kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now let's get down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Central Florida has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Michigan's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the Cubs.
But it does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup. And if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 28. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
Strike to the receiver, and down he goes at around the 44-yard line.
That brings him second and five.
From their own 44-yard line, second down. Room around the corner. He's brought down in the open field.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
He makes it to the 45-yard line. Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That'll bring up third and two.
He scrambles. Fumble! And who's got it? One of the defensive linemen. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
Quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's pushed out of bounds, right around the 42-yard line. It's second down, eight to go. Ball on their own 42. The ball. He's tackled around the 46-yard line.
Great job here in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Last time the offense had it, they lost a fumble. So I'm pretty sure the coaching staff was over there talking about ball security.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
That brings up second and nine.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. They'll bring him down around the 21-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He airs it out.
These guys were ready for the pass and played it well to come up with the deflection.
And this one is a beauty. He's to the 40. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. One play, he'll lose yards. Loss of one there for the halfback. From their own 44-yard line, second down. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion. Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He fields the punt at the 16. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far, Herbie.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
From their own 35-yard line, first down. And they make the stop at about the 33-yard line. Tackled at the 34-yard line.
That brings us third and 12.
Third down and 12. Ball on the 34. We've played one quarter. No score here. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's at midfield. At the 30. Tackle at the 23.
You know, there are certain teams in college football that can run the screen, and there are certain teams that run the screen and really do it well. This is an example of how you run the screen very well, and the timing between the quarterback and his running back, I think, is essential. We saw it here. The running back waits until the last second to go out to be able to make the reception, and the quarterback looks off the running back, looking downfield as if he's going to throw the ball downfield, and then again, the last second, just finds his running back, and there's two or three linemen in front of him, and that's when you're going to have a huge play. The timing and the rhythm of the screen pass is very important.
works his way out to about the 12. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. He's scrambling. And now he's going to improvise. Touchdown, Michigan.
He had the wherewithal to see the open space in front of him, and he just kept on zooming until he hit pay dirt.
And he tacks on the extra point. A six-play, 79-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Makes the catch, and look out. Brought down at the 38-yard line.
Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38. Tackle made at the 40. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. Throws on the run, gets it to the halfback, and he tackles him hard at the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, first down. And a quick throw. He's taken down at about the 19-yard line. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
The 19-yard line. It's first down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down around the 9-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
Second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Go four, two, 20. Go.
Zips it to the tight end. Touchdown, Knights. The extra point to tie this game up. Converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Makes the first down catch. And down he goes at the 44. From their own 44-yard line. First down. Got the corner. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a gain of five on one play.
Michigan will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. He's got room to run. Makes it to the 34. From the 34-yard line, first down. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground.
Gain of three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games, and we're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually, it could be the team that wins it.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. And he's tackled right away. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. 5-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
We've played a half of football. We're even at 7 in this one.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Great first half and a tight ball game. And we're set to start quarter number three.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. They'll bring him down at the 38. First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
The blockers tried to sell the misdirection, but the defender stayed home and made the play. That's the kind of effort a coach likes to see from his defense.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, four down. Here we go.
Gives it right side. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. From their own 32-yard line. Third down. Throws it to the outside. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Quick thinking there. You know, they're liable to put the ball in the air on third, so it's a smart play to keep your hands ready.
It out to about the 37-yard line. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Gets to about the 37-yard line. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 37. Wide. There's a fumble, and the ball bounces out of bounds. It's third down and six to go. Ball on the 40. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 49.
Sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From the 49-yard line, second down. Fires to the wideout, first down. He gets hit out of bounds at the 35.
First and goal.
first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Wolverines. And he hits the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Michigan's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Gets out to around the 38. From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop at the 41. Midfield. Complete. It's the junior. And he's tackled at the 41-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 41. He's got room. No play action. Good for about 4 yards.
Tight end does a good job here of selling his block and then getting out on his route and making a nice catch for a good game.
From the 37-yard line, second down. For a very long field goal attempt. It's up, and it sails right on him. No good. So they come up empty-handed there.
Kickers have to have a short memory. Just go out and make the next one.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receivers. Because, again, they put so much time into trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a player.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Michigan up 7 points. At about the 31.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 31-yard line, first down. Little handoff. Decent run here, right side.
That makes it 76.
Check, tight right, tight right, tight right.
here. Brought down at about the 27-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Tackle made at the 3-yard line. So at the end of the third quarter, the Wolverines lead 14-7. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Michigan is up 7. Looking for the corner. Touchdown, Michigan! Still a long ways to go here in the fourth quarter, but that score has certainly put them in a great position to win the football game. He makes the PAT. A 6-play, 64-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run, and just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Tackle made at the 26-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 30-yard line. Taken down at the 33. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. He's got it out to his tight end. And down he goes around the 49-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
From the 27-yard line, first down. He's on the run. He lets it go. Throws quickly into the end zone. Caught for the touchdown. How do they let the tight end get so open on such a big play?
That was poor defense. Looks like there was some miscommunication between the safety and the linebackers, which caused for him to get so open.
Tacks on the extra point. Central Florida ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Michigan is up by a touchdown.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's to the 40. He's tackled around the 45-yard line. From their own 45-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 43. He's going to try and scramble. Slides down. And he has a huge gain.
Yeah, I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
They hand it off. He makes his way to about the 32.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
From the 32-yard line, it's second down. Tackled and producing pickup. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And that quick intercepted. And he's level at the 21. Defense just stepped up and made the biggest play of the game. Just a huge interception. It's first and 10. Ball on the 21. Complete. They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they make the stop
at about the 43-yard line.
And he stops the clock with his fight. From their own 43-yard line, it's third down. Quick throw, and he's tackled right around the 28-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28. Hey, tackle immediately. The spike will stop the clock. He's in trouble. Quick pass. Touchdown, UCF. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up.
He got it.
Late in the fourth quarter, and with that score, we are now tied. And the way things are going, we might be going to an extra session or two. The Wolverines taking their first time out of the half. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Late in the fourth quarter, tie football game, an important game for both these teams, and this is where you find out who your leaders are. They'll have one more chance for the end zone. He's going to go for the home run. Doesn't get there. Well, that's the end of regulation, and this game is still unsettled, so we're going to overtime. And we're back ready now for overtime. Caught, open field. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the four, looking for Pater. Slings it. And he is drilled at the 9-yard line. That's a loss of 4 yards.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. Tackle around the 1 yard line.
That makes it third and goal.
This is where the defense makes a name for themselves. It's third down and goal from the one. And they got him for a loss.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. From the 25-yard line, first down. Got a man, watch out here. Hot down, and about the 15-yard line.
Great play. Tremendous effort to take advantage of the defense holding them to a field goal. They knew they were going to have a chance to win this, and they came through. Just a fantastic finish.
Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. Central Florida, 27. Michigan, 24. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.